It is reported in Sahih Bukhari and Hadith and Muslim and Muttafaq alayh by Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He says, Inna Aba Bakrin kana yusalli lahum fi waja in nabiyyi alladhi tuwaffa fi tuwaffiya fi hatta iza kana yawm al-ithnain wa hum sufufan fi as-salah fa kashafa an-nabiyyu sitra al-hujra yanzuru ilayna wa huwa qa'imun kana wajhu warakatu mushafin thumma tabassama yadhaku fahamamna an naftatina min al-farh bi salat min al-farh bi ru'yat an-nabiyyi fa naqasa Abu Bakr ala kibayl yasil as-saffa wa dhanna anna an-nabiyya kharijun ila as-salat فَأَشَارَ إِلَيْلَ النَّبِيِّ أَنَّتِمُّ صَلَاتَكُمْ وَرْخَسْتِرْ فَتُوَفِّيَ فِي يَوْمِهِ Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم How the companions used to Holy Prophet, love Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Their whole concept of deen, their whole concept of worship, their whole concept of iman, their whole concept of attachment to Holy Prophet, their whole concept of spiritual attachment to Almighty Allah, their whole concept of spirituality, their whole concept of spiritual uplift, everything was based on the concept of love to Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It comes in Bukhari and Muslim. Then Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq was leading the ritual prayer. It was Monday when beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was ill. He raised the curtain of his sacred chamber, and Anas ibn Malik says that he bless us with his compassionate gaze, which we are missing for the last 3 days restlessly, and we were waiting for him impatiently. The shining, the beautiful face of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seemed to us while we were praying. They were praying, they were facing towards Kaaba, and Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam house was towards extreme left. His house was not in front of him. The companions and Abu Bakr Siddiq, while worshipping and praying, they were facing towards Kaaba. So they were not watching towards the door of Holy Prophet. They were concentrating on the place of prostration, and they were busy in their prayer when Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam raised the curtain to see how his companions, how his servants, how his believers, and how his true followers are worshipping behind Abu Bakr Siddiq. So his effulgent face of Holy Prophet, when it came, the illuminated pages, they see, when we saw the face of Holy Prophet, it looked like the open pages of Holy Quran. The shining face of Holy Prophet looked like the illuminating face page of Quran. He felt pleased, and then he smiled. I am quoting this hadith from Bukhari and Muslim, muttafaq alayh, unanimous hadith. And he said, we had nearly ended and broken our ritual prayer because of the extreme love and joy in order to see the shining face of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look how to restore the balance of faith today. How to restore the balance between connection to Allah and connection to Holy Prophet. How to restore this iman, balance of iman. Look at the practice and sunnah and seerah and faith of the companions. Nobody in this whole world does possess the better degree of iman than companions. No one in this world possess the better state of iman than Abu Bakr, Umar, Usman, and Ali. And it's not a matter of one companion or two companions. The whole Jamaat of the Sahaba were praying behind Abu Bakr Siddiq when Holy Prophet took up the curtain of his house in order to watch how my loving companions are praying and worshipping Almighty Allah. And he was on their extreme left. Extreme left. He was not in front of them. When they heard removing the curtain, they understood that Hazrat Aisha or the wives of Holy Prophet, they can't remove the curtain. This can only be Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam who has removed the curtain, and definitely he must be standing on the door. While they were praying and worshipping Almighty Allah, so everybody look at extremity of the love of companions. This is how we have to restore the balance. This is how we have to bring the balance of Iman back to our lives. This is how we have to achieve the success of Iman. And this is how we have to create the true balance of faith in our actual lives through the practice and conduct and behaviors of the companions. So what did the companion do when they heard the removal of curtains? They turned their faces from Kaaba towards Kaaba of Kaaba. Face of Prophet Muhammad was the Kaaba of Kaaba. Kaaba was in front of their eyes, and Kaaba of Kaaba was in front on the left side of the mosque. They forget the direction of Kaaba. They forget in which condition they were standing. Look at the position of love of the Holy Prophet of the companions. Look their ishq, look their love, look their mahabba, look their attachment, look their loyalty, look their spiritual condition of heart. They turned their faces towards the door of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And hadith of Bukhari says, fahamamna an naftatina min al farah bi ru'yat an nabiy sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when we gazed, when we saw the shining, the beautiful face of my beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the curtain was raised, every companion forgot his worshipping, forgot the state of Salat. Everybody was indulged in looking into the beauty of face of Holy Prophet, their beloved. They forgot which condition they were standing in, what act they were performing. They got busy in gazing the beauty of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, looking at him. And then the beautiful words, this was what happened to the companions. And this situation created a big change, because when Holy Prophet's face came in front of them, their illuminating face created some light which affected Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq. He understood that Holy Prophet must have come out while praying Almighty, worshipping Almighty Allah. Out of the respect and reverence of Holy Prophet, Abu Bakr Siddiq left his musalla and came back. Siddique-akbar is leaving his musalla. Here lies the concept of combination between Tawheed and Risala. Today the people just talk of Tawheed, a blind concept of Tawheed. They don't understand what Tawheed is and where Tawheed has come from. They don't understand what concept of Risala is and what kind of devotion, attachment and love the concept of Risala demands from us. If we want to restore the balance of Iman in our lives, we have to follow the footsteps of Abu Bakr, Umar and Usman and Ali. So they forgot their state. All of them turned towards the face of Holy Prophet. فَهَمَمْنَا أَن نَفْتَاتِنَا مِنَ الْفَرْحِ بِرُوْيَةِ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ. These are the words of Sahih Bukhari, that everybody, when he gazed and saw the beautiful shining face of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they forgot their prayer. And everybody was just absorbed in looking into the beauty of the face of Prophet Muhammad. And whatever they did, they had nearly ended. In hadith, they say, we had nearly ended our ritual prayer due to the extreme joy of having blissful and heartening glimpse of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam face. Abu Bakr Siddiq also felt as if Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had come out for the ritual prayer, so he initiated to drag himself on his soles to join the first row. He left the musalla. When Holy Prophet saw the whole situation was changed, gave us the gesture to complete his prayer. He gave us a gesture to complete the prayer, and he pulled the curtain down and went back, departed us on that day. If we want to restore the balance of Iman, if we want to re-achieve the beauty of Iman, if we want to re-achieve the completion and perfection of Iman, it would be impossible without following into the footsteps of Abu Bakr, Umar and Usman and Ali, which they performed in front of Holy Prophet. Holy Prophet would have asked them that you had done wrong. Why have you turned your faces? Why have you disturbed your prayer because me? No, Holy Prophet knew whether they look at Kaaba or they look at me, because Kaaba was Kaaba and the face of Prophet Muhammad was Kaaba of Kaaba. It was Kaaba of Kaaba. So turning their face towards Prophet Muhammad did not break their prayers. Rather, this was a spiritual perfection of their prayers.